Hey everyone, happy Wednesday. Thanks for popping in tonight here. I appreciate it, guys. Thanks replay viewers for watching, and thank you YouTube viewers for watching. This will go up on YouTube at Penguin and Fish Movies, so you can check it out there. And it will also stay here on Facebook on the Penguin and with an ampersand Fish Facebook page. So thanks guys for watching and rewatching. All right, I'm going to flip you around and we'll get going for the night. Hey everyone, happy Wednesday. So we are working on the Splendid Sampler quilt along. Here we are, block 93 is what we're going to continue on tonight. We finished block 94 yesterday, which was awesome. It's so fun to finish a block before a new block day. So we have an extra day to work on another block, and we're going to work on block 93, a little bit more foundation paper piecing on that tonight. So if you're new here, guys, my name is Alyssa Thomas from Penguin and Fish, where we make lovely and quirky hand embroidery patterns and kits. I am the author of Sew and Stitch Embroidery and a fabric designer, and I'm here every weeknight at 9:30 p.m. Central. So thanks so much for coming in. Oh, hello everyone, thanks for coming in. Mary Beth, you caught me live. That's so nice, Marianne, nice to see you. All right, let's flip around and get going tonight. I wanna see how far I can get on this tonight. All right, here we go. Okay, we worked on this last night as well, and we were able to not only finish block 94, but we were able to put this piece onto all of our 8 pieces here. So all we have left, you know, we still have our A and B pieces that are, they're basically a mirror image of each other. They're kind of like this. So all we have left are these two and these two, and these are opposites, and these are opposites as well. So we will continue on that tonight. So next up, we did A4, then A5, then A6. So A5 is next, so we're gonna deal with this big triangle. I'm assuming it's the same here. B3, oh, interesting. So B3, B4, B5. On the B side, we're doing the small one first. I suppose it doesn't really matter because they're kind of like the B is separated, the B5 is separated from the B4. So at this point, it wouldn't really matter which side you really did first. But we'll, you know what? I'm tempted to just keep doing the same thing. So I think instead of doing the small one and the big one here, we're going to do it the same way we're going to do this one. So let's do the big ones first, and then we'll do the small ones. The only benefit I could see from doing the small one and the big one, like the next in line for each, is that we'd be using the same fabric. So maybe that's worth doing it that way. So, all right, fine. We'll do it how the instructions say. How about that? We'll do B4 next and A5 next, which are the next in line for each piece, and it'll be these blues. So we're gonna do it by fabric, not by shape. So I might cut out all of them right away though, because we do need like the mirror images of this one for the other side. So that's how you did it, Jennifer, you did it by fabric. Okay, that's good to know. All right, looks like I have a ton of fabric of this blue, so we shouldn't have any problem getting a nice strip of fabric that we can start cross cutting. I only have my small little, I didn't get my big cutting board out tonight, so let's just fold this in half to cut a nice straight line. All right, let's not get ahead of ourselves. Let's start there. First of all, we gotta do the postcard part of this process. So let's get the cutting board and let's get the postcard out, and we'll prep the A5 piece and the B4 piece. So we are gonna cover up, make sure this is all lined flat here. I'm gonna cover up everything before the A5, just revealing the A5 there. This is so we can get really nice, oh, move that little piece to. This is so we can get nice quarter inch seam allowances. So let's fold it up against that postcard and get our add a quarter ruler out. You can use a normal ruler as well, but I like to add a quarter. Yeah, maybe we'll just go one color at a time. I won't worry about cutting all the pieces right now. Let's just deal with one idea at a time so I don't get totally confused. All right, I'm going to put all the A pieces together and all the B pieces together. That will keep me a little less confused. Okay, that one's done. I just want to make sure that I'm doing the big piece on the A's and the small piece on the B's. So there we go. And because we went into the seam allowance on that, on the one way, it wants to undo itself there, which is fine at this point. So let's cut that. That's two. This is the third. 3 out of 4. Let's just tear this away a little bit. Can't believe the week's halfway over already. Well, that means we get it's New Block Thursday tomorrow, block 95. So we are getting down towards the end of these. Just the 6 more blocks to go. Kind of crazy. And I'm still out of the teens for my unfinished block, so that's nice. I have 12 unfinished blocks, so just out of the teens. All right, and that's it. Oop, didn't cut that enough. Probably still need to switch my blade. Haven't done that yet. All right, A5s are ready to go. Let's prep the B pieces right away. Now in this case, we're doing the B4s. B4 comes after the B3. Hey, Maureen! These are the small pieces now, but we're gonna do the small pieces for the B's. Get that little nick out of the way down there. Cruising along with this block, it's been going for paper piecing. I think it's been going really quickly, and I think it's because I'm doing all the pieces all at once versus just sticking with the one section, doing like A1 through A6 all at once. Instead of that, I'm doing all the A1s and all the A2s all together, and I think that's speeding up the process. So two more, and then we'll be ready to cut fabric. Oh, Maureen, I'm sorry to hear that. I hope everything's okay. All right, one more here. And we'll be good to go. B4. Yeah, assembly line is going super well. I wouldn't necessarily recommend it if you're just starting out, because it might get confusing really quick. But if you've done it a few times, then this assembly line thing really speeds up the process a bit. All right, so we have all of our, here's our A pieces and our B pieces. They're all prepped. So let's cut the blue big squares, and then we'll cut the blue little squares. And we'll be able to start sewing just about. All right, so my plan kind of is to just cut some strips that would be big enough for all these pieces. So like if I cut a strip like this, I can cross cut these triangles out of it. So all I need is a couple of good straight edges. So I am, that fold that we just did, I am putting that fold on a straight edge here, like parallel to it. So that's pretty good with that generous quarter inch seam allowance. And I'm gonna just cut what a generous seam allowance would be on this side too. And this is looking just fine. So we'll go right there and then I'll cross cut a bunch of triangles out of here. And you know what? I'm gonna give this other side a nice good straight edge too, since we'll be treating that as a straight edge. So here's the deal with this fabric though, which may get a little confusing to me. There's no right side or wrong side with this. So I have to pay really close attention to how I'm doing the triangles to make sure that I have right sides together. Because if I don't have right sides together for how I cut it, when I sew it and unfold it, they won't match up properly. So I gotta imagine right now that it's the wrong side, or that the right side is down. And I'm gonna just slowly cut these one at a time and place them right away just so I don't forget. So, all right, here will be our first one. So I'm gonna just cut up at an angle there. All right, now here's where I gotta remember. So my right side was down. So if I do right sides together, then I would be like this, which makes sense because then when I flip it, it'll be like that. So all right, I'm placing this where it needs to be right away. So I don't lose my mind. I'm gonna make a nice stack over there. Oh, I'm glad you're doing better, Marine. That's scary stuff. But glad you're okay. All right, here's the next one. Let's get that generous seam allowance around it. I think we're perfectly fine. I'm just gonna slice across here. All right, so again, okay, right side was down. So this would be right sides together. All right, that is that piece. I'm gonna just make a nice stack here. And see, I'm just trading them back and forth to get the most out of this rectangle as I can. I'll cut with the scissors this way, so I don't accidentally cut through any of my fabric down here. Okay, let's get those right sides together again. That's the third one. And last one here. So we were able to fit a lot out of that rectangle. We can get a few more out of here. So there we go. Just cross cut across here. And put right sides together again, just so I don't forget. Okay, let's go ahead and do the B pieces right away. So again, I might as well use the scrap here. Let's see, yeah, I might as well. Yeah, I got it here, let's use it. All right, so I'm going on a straight edge here again. I wonder if I can get, I might be able to get, well, nah, I can't get four out of here. It's not big enough for that. So let's try and get two out of it. So I'll get one in both directions. We'll get one here, or I hope I will. Might be able to squeeze one out of this piece. Maybe if this is the straight edge, that would work. All right, right sides together here. Be like this. job for us.
Yep.
Okay. I think we can get one more out of this. Let's see if I can use this straight edge that's already cut nicely. Yeah, I think I can. Awesome. All right, the right sides together there. Probably be easier to go like this, but actually it would. Let's just cut a straight edge here and be done with it. Then I don't have to worry as much, I don't think. It's kind of with the scissors that you're using today. They cut very nicely. Oh no! They cut the tip of your finger. Ugh. Oh my gosh. That's not cool. Oh, I'm sorry to hear that. Yes, they are sharp little buggers, these Kai scissors. Oof. I hope you got it, I don't know, stitched up or whatever you needed to do to it, Marjorie. Ugh. That's scary. All right, let's get two more out of here, maybe this little bit right here. Yikes, not fun. All right, let's go. We'll just do it the blob way of doing it. I'm just gonna cut a blob around here. I think this straight edge is straight enough. Snip those off. Snip these off. Alright, that should align here. And one more, and then we can sew. I don't know if I can fit one here anymore, though. Maybe if I use this as my diagonal again. So let's extend our blob. Ooh, that's quite a bit, but that's okay. Okay, and then let's just get another nice straight edge here. Oh gosh, ish. I have like a super big phobia of cutting myself with one of these scary cutting utensils. Oh, that's no fun. Blah. All right, that's our last one. I think these should all be big enough that I don't really have to test it too much. So, all right. Let's sew these. I am officially done with this fabric, so that can go away. We only have the one fabric left, but first let's sew this up. So let's try, I'm going to try and do that chain sewing again too, chain piecing, just so we can all continue our fast-pacedness of this all. So let's turn it on, and I'm going to just line these up again. I'm going to do a little test. I'm not going to do my whole pin test, but I'm just kind of doing a little flip test quickly, just kind of estimating a quarter inch and flipping it up. And if it covers it, then I'm thinking I'm probably fine. I cut all of my pieces big enough that I think I'll be okay. So, all right, we are starting with our B pieces. Because I just stacked them and those are on top. I think it was probably a good idea to go by color versus shape. I think this is going to work just fine. So just a little back tacking. Yeah, I think it definitely goes faster this way, the whole assembly line process of it all. Making sure my edges are together. You know, we don't need, this is all kind of in my way. I don't need any of that. Let's trim that. Then when we chain piece it, it's not as big as a jump. I don't have to sew through all that fabric hanging out on the edge. Next up, again, I'm just a little antsy about these, so I'm doing that test. I don't think it's really necessary, but just because my pieces aren't big enough. That's why I like cutting the big blob, then I don't have to worry about them not matching up as much. This is our last B piece. All right, that one still covers. And the threads are definitely easier to cut this way too. Yeah, you're right. You're right, Jennifer. Doing this chain piecing, then we don't have all the long strands. I mean, again, you can't always do this. We're lucky because we're going from seam allowance to seam allowance on all these triangles. So that was a neat little feature of this block, so that does allow us to chain piece it, because sometimes in paper piecing it'll meet up with another shape, like there could be a shape right here, so this line would have bumped into that shape, and in that case we'd have to jump to the next piece, and you know, that doesn't make for easy chain piecing. All right, B pieces are done, so here let's start our A pieces. Over. All right. I think we should do pretty well on this tonight. We'll see. So we just have to do this with the one more piece, and then that's it for the sewing of it all, the one more fabric. So we'll press this, we'll trim them and then press them and do the one more fabric. I'm thinking we should get to all that tonight. But it's kind of crazy. I mean, we're doing 8 pieces right now, right? And if we would have gone through all of just one, like A1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, we might have only got to like A4. The whole entire evening, or we might have finished just this one piece, but that's still only 5 pieces. We're doing 8 pieces right now, and we'll probably get another 8 done. So that's like 16 pieces in one sitting versus the 5 that we might have been able to do if we had gone just all one at a time. You know, this whole process, the assembly line way of doing this, it just, you're doing the like with like for longer, so there's less moving around and all that, and I think that really speeds up the process. Less fumbling with the tools. It is just speedier. But, you know, you can really only do that with, well, I don't know if this is true, but it makes it easier that all these pieces are pretty much the same. If all these pieces, like the dress block, for example, where we paper piece that cute little dress, that would have been more difficult to assembly line because every single section looked completely different. So that one was more of a one at a time paper piece one. But where all these sections are all really similar, it makes it really easy to do it this way. Last one right here. I love that I don't have to worry about my scant quarter inch. I can just sew on that line. That makes things nice. Okay. Let's snip that. All right, I'll scooch over here. So now we have that long chain of these, which is super cute. We basically made some garland. Let's snip all those. So that's a nice thing about chain piecing. It just has this little bit of thread in between. We don't have like long threads to snip off of every single one of these. All right, here are the bees. And cutting that leader off of here. Okay, done with that. Let's press them. So heading up here. Again, I like to put the ink side down so it doesn't get in my iron. Let's just give that a little warm-up press. I think my iron is full of fuzz and it's not warm yet. Or it turned itself off. So let's give it a moment. So I press it to kind of set the seam, and then I'm going to finger press it over like this. Finger press where I sewed, and then where it's not sewn on the edges, I just extend the finger pressing. You really start to see how that white's going to jump off of this dark background that we're putting in now. There, like, see how, look how sharp that line is. That's nice, I like it. Okay, that's one. Let's do the rest of them, all eight of them. Then we'll be moving on to the last piece of all these. That's nice. Yeah, I think it was a good idea to stick with the one color versus the similar shapes. I think in this case that worked out just fine. It seems it didn't bring up any weird issues or anything. I'm perfectly happy doing it that way. The nice thing is now I can put this fabric back into my fabric bin and use it for other blocks. I had been saving it for this block because if I didn't save it and I didn't get this block done, then I would have ran out of fabric probably working on another block because I'd forget that I was saving it for this. So I put all of this fabric with this block. And now that I'm getting done with certain colors, I can put it back in my bin and actually use it. That's nice. Ooh, now we're on the eight pieces. Oh, that's no fun. Takes over 3 hours to do two. Only spins when it feels like it. Oh, Jennifer, that sounds like a pile and not fun. Doing the wash. Yeah, that's the worst when something like that. Our sink just, the garbage disposal in our sink, which is connected to the dishwasher and everything else, died the other day. So we had John's uncle came over and helped us, helped him fix it. Him, not us, I didn't do anything. But, that was yesterday. So, like, we couldn't use the dishwasher or the sink or anything, really, without it leaking. So we had, like, a bowl underneath to collect water. Now it works perfectly. So, but, man, it stinks when those normal household-y guys die on you. All right, last one. And then we'll get the postcard out and trim our seam allowance for the last bit, our last fabric. It'll be this purpley, yellowy, dark, flowery one. All right, there we go. Back to square one. Oh, Donna, it is not going well. I gotta get back on it again. It seems like whenever I get out of my normal, all right, we're gonna cut that A1 piece now. Not cut it, but hold it. But whenever I get out of my normal day, it takes me like so long to get back on it. I don't know what it is. And I don't know how all these people who, like, they just keep, who travel a lot that can keep their exercise going. I don't know. But we remember all those boxes. I know, routine, I gotta get it in. That's what I'm trying to figure out. How can I get this into my routine consistently? So So I gotta get back on it tomorrow for sure. But yeah, like, I don't get it. Like, any routine break and everything goes out the window. Like, my food and exercise and all of it. So I gotta get back on it. We moved all those boxes. Remember, I had all those boxes here for, that I had a nice big order that I'm gonna tell you guys. I'll share more about that real soon, but I had all those boxes, if you remember, I showed them to you here, and we spent a couple days moving them, and so I was all weird and sore from that, and now I feel like I'm recovering from just that, so I don't know. Today I was just tired. But you know what? We went out for pizza yesterday. Like, the day before, I was all ready to go, and I got so much done that day. But we had eaten really well that day. And yesterday, we went out for pizza, and I feel like today I'm totally draining, and I'm wondering if it was because of that pizza being just, like, off, you know, my normal, you know, in theory, healthier eating routine. So I don't know. I'm a little perturbed about today, about my routine. Need to get back, waking up early, exercising and eating right, and going to bed early, and getting a lot done during the day. So how do I manage all that, people? That's what I'm trying to figure out. I need to get it all, I need to trick myself and get it all, like, in a routine. All right, here are the A pieces. So the A pieces are those big ones again. But yeah, the exercising on vacation. I know, like, people go on vacation and then they wake up early and go for a jog or whatever. Oh gosh, I just can't wrap my head around that quite yet. Maybe I'll get there someday. Oh, no. Oh, you both have colds. You totally run down. Came in the day off. Oh, no, that's good. I mean, that's definitely important, I think, if you're not feeling well, like, straight up cold or something like that. I mean, I don't know. I don't think it's ever good to just force it. I don't know. Super duper exercise. People might disagree, but I don't know. I think you gotta do all on those days. You gotta do all those things that get you back to health for sure. Oh, that Donna, I feel ya. I'm exactly like that. If I miss it, it's the lack of routine. If I miss that, then I feel like I have to start all over, and my body feels like it's starting all over again too, which is annoying. All right, one more to cut, and then we can cut our fabric out. Okay, thought I had something folded over there. It felt kind of thick. All right, and... Ooh, that's exciting, Donna. Sometimes, you know, it's nice to gamify it like that. So, like, doing a challenge or something like that where you feel like you have this goal and that has a end point, you know? That big goal with an end point, I think that's important for getting things done or reaching, like, goals. I'm all about the gamifying of things and tricking yourself to do things in any way possible. All right, here, and now we got this nice, we can start seeing the shape of our cute little sun ray there, I suppose. All right, we got our A pieces on top, and our B pieces are below. So let's do the same thing. I think look at a hidden little piece here. I was looking for that fabric. That's all I have left of that one. Ooh, wow, I have a lot of this. So, I'm going to do the same thing, and you know what? I think I'll have enough with this short side here. I'm going to cut a piece that will get me all of these larger triangle pieces in. Oh, I don't even have a scale. I can't have those in my house. That'd be too dangerous. Be just checking that all the time. All right. So let's cut it so I have my generous kind of seam allowance going here. That looks pretty good. And I'll trim off a straight edge here as well. I fold it in half to do this just because I only have my little cutting board here. It's nice to just get out my little itty bitty cutting board now though, instead of getting out the big one. Although it is nice having the whole surface area to cut, the whole tabletop area to cut. All right, don't need him. Love the banter while you're eating a cupcake. Oh man, I wanted a donut today, which is just weird. I don't ever like have donuts really, or it's just not often, but man, I could have had a donut today. If there was a cupcake in the house, I would be eating it, that's for sure. I can't have any of that stuff in the house. If I have any like bad stuff in the house, that'll be it. That'll be all I eat. So I have to not have it in here. I have no self-control, no willpower. All right, let's get our triangles out of here. The no stacking after dinner. Ooh, wow, maybe I should try that. What works best for me is stocking the fridge with everything healthy and having it ready to go. Then when I'm tired and, you know, only want crappy stuff to eat, and I open the fridge and there isn't any crappy stuff, it's all healthy and it's all, like, cooked and ready to go, or snack size, like carrots are cut up and all that, or I can just grab a hard-boiled egg or whatever, then I'm like, ah, okay, fine, I'll have this. And then I feel better, you know? Because I ate something healthy, but I need that trick. Like, it doesn't work for me otherwise. It needs to be there and available. Oh gosh, yeah, I can't, Donna, same thing. I cannot have sweets like that in the house at all. That'll seriously be all I eat. I can't have it around. I can't even have, like, cereal, because that's just sugary enough that, you know, even, like, non-sugary cereal, it's just snacky enough that I will only snack on that and I'll eat it all. So we pile the fridge with vegetables, and I've been trying to get the crock pot, the slow cooker going again, so I don't have to think about food in the evenings. We gotta get back on that. We're not great at that yet. I don't know. All those tricks. Ooh, I love dark chocolate. Yeah. Chocolate, I'm pretty good at having just like one or two small pieces of it, but we only buy dark chocolate when we buy it to Jennifer, so you can't, I mean, like, I can't just eat the whole thing. Oh, God. I would eat, see, those Girl Scout cookies, though, I would eat all of those at once. For sure. I would eat it till I felt super sick and I'd be like, I don't care. They're so good. I need to keep eating them. Or I'd stop for just long enough to, I don't know, get some coffee and then I would eat more of them. All right. Now we just have these little ones. Oh, you know what? I bet you I can cut this. This is almost like a triangle or almost square. I bet you I can just trim it in half this way and get two out of that, if that's my straight edge. Oop. That should be plenty. Yeah! Alright. That's one. And two. And then I just need to find fabric for two more. Oh, this is kind of an odd shaped piece, though. Let's test this one quick. About right there, maybe. Oh, yeah. We'll still be. Oh, thank you. You gave half of me. That are funny. It's only kind of good for you. Yeah, dark chocolate. Oh man, I would. I don't want dark chocolate. I eat it immediately till it's gone. Oh, you can't save it for later. So, if I have like my crux, like when the Hubs and I really lose all willpower altogether, we will he'll get a bag. Like we'll have to just get these things. He'll get a bag of peanut M&Ms, and I will get a bag of jelly beans, and we'll eat the whole thing all at once. That's my kicker. I don't know what it is. I like the texture of them or something. And those Brock's jelly beans at Easter are the best, but I'll settle for jelly bellies from the CVS. It's bad. We don't do that all that often, but every once in a while, we just can't help ourselves. All right, I'll punch from these guys off of here. But yeah, when we do have chocolate, I have to, we voluntarily hide it so it's out of sight. Even though I know where it is and I know where to get it, if it's out of sight, I'll forget about it. And then instead of eating it all day, then we'll just be like, oh yeah, we have chocolate in the evening. And then we'll have a piece or two. And then I hide it again. Yeah, we try not to get that stuff too often. But seriously, I just need, if I have the fridge stocked up with healthy, snacky stuff that I can just grab, that usually does the job well enough. All right, I think we're good. Oops, not anymore, I moved it. This is our last piece here. Yeah, chips or any of that. I can't have any of that in the house or I'll eat all of it. Eats lollies? Oh, that's funny. I know. It's those husbands, huh? Buying all that stuff. All right, let's try chain piecing this again so it goes nice and quick. Yep, if they're out of sight, then it's a little more difficult. But man, I don't know. I'm in an effort now to not purchase that stuff. But man, it's hard to keep up with it though, having stuff all ready to go in the house. All right, this little piece of paper is popping up, so I'm just gonna push it down. There we go. But it's kind of like always on my mind, like, do we have enough stuff in the fridge ready to go to cook so I don't, because if I don't, then I immediately want to fall into the crappy food, or we'll go out to eat and have crappy food, so it needs to be all ready and available for me. This is the last B piece. This one has that little bunny on, but I don't think we'll. Oops, let's flatten this out. I don't think we'll get that bunny in here, though. Ah, it's bunching up here. I thought I'd maybe be able to sew over it, but I guess not. My fabric was bunching, but I didn't bother with it because I knew I was going to cut it off later. But. All right, now on to the A pieces. Four more bits and then we're done sewing the pieces. Woo! Next we'll get to, after we press them, we'll get to trim them all. And when we trim them all, that's when things start looking like they're coming together. So that'll be fun to get to that part. I feel like I might not be paying attention to this as much as I should be. I'm hoping I'm getting the right sides together and sewing on the right line and everything. I think I am. That's another thing about doing the chain piecing. You kind of get using muscle memory because every piece is the same. You're doing the same thing on each one. All right, last one. I have the slow cooker going right now with soup stock. So it smells like soup in here. It's making me hungry for soup while we sit here. All right. Now we got our little garland of chain piecing going again here. I think that's so fun. So fun to have this crazy long piece. All right, let's trim them all. Flip them all the same way still though. These pets sitting. Oh, you did it! Got it all put together in rows, only to have room for a few of these last ones I posted today. Oh, cool. That's awesome. So you did the one where it looks like it has like that little shadow on it. I thought that was such a neat setting. Like, it was just clever. I liked it. These are the A pieces now. I'll have to check it out on Facebook. All right, there we go. Yep, it's veggie stock, but it's got some meat bones in there, and I'm not even sure what the meat is. All right, I'm not sure what the bones are. My husband had it might be pork. It's either a pork or a beef bone that we just had in the fridge from, I don't know why he had it. They were wrapped up, but I threw that in and a bunch of vegetables. So whenever I'm chopping carrots and celery and onions, all the remnants of that, like the ends that and the leaves that I'm not going to use, I throw it into a freezer bag in the fridge, in the freezer, I mean. And whenever I want to make soup stock, like if I have chicken bones or some sort of bone lying around, I will throw that in some water with all those carrot and celery and onion bits that I've been saving. So yeah, so whenever I'm prepping. I'll just save those three though. I mean, I'm not saving, like, broccoli bits would be pretty gross in there, I think. But celery and carrots and onion together and garlic, those scraps I'll throw in the slow cooker. And I just actually started using the slow cooker for that. But I let it go for a really long time. I let it go overnight, like about, almost 20 hours. Just cooking away on low. That's been really yummy. Been doing that lately, trying to make more soup stock, soup again. Ooh, I got a little bit of that bunny in there. But yeah, I mean, I could do it just the veggie stuff, but I want to do it with the bones, because that's supposed to be like getting, what is it? The, like breaking down the bone and stuff. That's supposed to be really good for your health. The bone broth of it all, the bone part of it. I forget. I know all the science behind it, but It's that time of night when all that goes out the window. But I use it for soup, and then I'm trying to do that thing where you heat it up and you drink just a cup of the broth. You know, almost as if it's tea. And I'm trying to get my head wrapped around that. So, it's actually really good. I like drinking a lot of hot drinks during the day, so I'll have like coffee and tea and all that during the day. So the bone broth is just an extra little addition to my hot drinks, my hot comfy drinks during the day. All right, we have one more to press and then we're done. We can trim all these out. So tonight we'll probably, yeah, the gelatin thing, like I forget what it is. It's, good stuff in there for like skin and hair and your insides and all that. I don't know. I'll have to look it all up again. All right, here we go. So tonight yet, I think we will just, ooh, my camera's not moving right. There we go. We will trim these because that's always the best part, cleaning these all up. Because they still look like blobs, right? But the moment we clean them up, then they're all fancy and we'll put them together. So that's great. We'll have all the pieces done. And then the next time we have a free day and, you know, maybe we'll do a mini marathon on Saturday again. We will, maybe we'll finish this one up on Saturday. But we'll have all the pieces done so I don't have to save any fabric or anything anymore. All right, let's trim this. So I am using this line as my guide. I'm not just looking at this outside edge and using the outside edge. Like, I'm not lining this up with the outside edge. I'm gonna line it up with that quarter inch. So I'm gonna find the quarter inch line, line up the quarter inch line on that printed line, and then cut. I'll have a more accurate quarter inch seam allowance if I do that. So this will take a little while yet, cutting all these. Ooh, I can use my spinny dough. Hey, that's gonna make it more fun. I'm gonna cut these little nicks out of it too. I do kind of find that it helps. It makes it easier lining up the sides later. Oh, I like the spinnies. Alright, so I'm gonna just quickly, I'll just do that with the rotary cutter. I'm gonna snip these little edges too. Okay, and here is what our piece looks like. Super clean and fancy. All right, I'm gonna just start a stack of these and we'll keep cutting. I wanna lay them all out when I'm done here too, tonight, so we can see, we'll finally be able to kinda get a better gist of what this is gonna look like. So that'll be fun. Just gotta cut them all out. We'll be here a little while yet. Oh! I don't know, am I frozen, guys? On my end, it doesn't say that my signal's weak or anything like that, so as far as I know, we're still good to go here. Here's the second piece. Oh, you're fine? Okay, good. Another B piece. We're getting all our B pieces done first. The A pieces are the ones that have that little pinwheel triangles on there. So that'll be cute to see what those look like.
look like.
I just enjoy using my new spinny cutting mat. This is worth all the cutting just to spin this around a few times. Oh, I'm in a different time zone today and almost missed it. Well, I'm glad you made it, Laverne. Alright, cutting these little nicks out of it. You don't really need to cut these little bits out, but it does actually really help line things up easier when we put the whole thing together. It's a little extra step. I think it's worth it though. This is our last V piece. A lot of seams to go through there. And my soup stock is smelling good. The nice thing too about doing that in the slow cooker, so supposedly, I've done this a couple times, but you can reuse the bones. Like, I made some of this last night. I had some soup stock going here last night when I was here too, and I let that go overnight, and I reused the bones today to make more. I just have to put different vegetables in. But you can do it a couple times. So really, you're really, really breaking down those bones, which are good. All right, that's the last of the bees. Here's the A with that cute little yellow piece in. Alrighty. I know, halfway done with cutting. We're getting there. I am really happy with how quick this piece, this block is going. I don't think I started it right on the day. I think this was Sunday's. Wait, no, this wasn't Sunday's block. This was Thursday's block. Oh yeah, so I only did it Thursday and Friday. So I worked on it 2 days. And I think one day was completely just prepping it. I think we just colored it in. I don't think we did anything else on it that first day. Maybe we did, I can't remember. But then we just worked on it a little bit yesterday and today. I mean, we will need one more sitting, but as far as a paper piece block with this many pieces and this many segments, I think it sped along rather quickly. I think a lot faster than when we started the Splendid Sampler. Ooh, that one's cute. I like that one. All right, I'm going to just put the A's that way. 3 more, and then we can lay it out. This is a little putsy. You know what's going to be putsy is once we have this sewn together, taking out all the papers of all 8 segments. But I guess, you know, not any putsier than in any of the other paper piece projects because they all end up being 6.5 inches. So you're just doing 6.5 inches worth of taking paper out. Reaching the end. It's that reaching the end feeling. All right, that's our second one. 2 more. So nice when the blobs start turning into perfect shapes with perfect seam allowances. I think that's why paper piecing is so fun. Everything turns out perfect. Ooh, we got a funny little texture piece there. Pre-cutting the blobs and doing all the same letters at once. Yeah, I think so too, Kathleen. That's not always how I did this, that I sort of started that on the Splendid Sampler here, and I think that was a good move. I mean, again, it only works real well when, you know, on blocks like this where we have segments that all feel the same. But luckily we have a lot of those on the, or we've had several of those on the Splendid Sampler. But yeah, I think this definitely went much faster than if we wouldn't have done it that way. So I'm happy with that. And it's more enjoyable. Like, just chain piecing is just fun. All right, one more. Let me get to lay it out. I'm excited. I mean, you know, it still took days to do. You know, and, you know, you could get it done in an afternoon, a long afternoon, probably. Oh, gosh, maybe a long, long afternoon. But, you know, I'm only doing it in the evenings here, so for me it took days still. And we're not done yet. We still got to sew all the pieces together, and that'll take a good chunk of time, too. But I'm feeling pretty fast with it, still, considering it's still a paper piecing. I mean, it's still 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That's 24 pieces for the A's and 20 pieces for the B's. So that's still like 44 pieces that we're paper piecing. That's kind of I don't know, for this amount of time, I think we've gotten a lot done pretty quickly. Ooh, you'll be paper piecing cards. Oh, that's sweet. All right, there we are. They're all cut, so let's lay them out. I'm dying to see what it's gonna look like. So I'm shushing all my fabric out of the way. And you know what? I think I'll put it on my nice white board right away. This is with I have this little tag board. This is what I do my, take my final photo on, but I think it always looks nice. Ooh, my chalk one. So, all right, we gotta go the A's and B's. So this is where I always mess up a little bit. I'm not the best at figuring out where all the triangles go. So remember, we still are going to have, you know, overlap. So this won't be exactly, it'll still shrink up a bit. But we'll get it's starting to form, I can see it. Oh. This blue won't run into this other blue because those seam allowances will be gone. So it'll be more like that. So the design will change a little bit because of that. So right now it looks like this blue is going into that blue. I don't think it'll look like that once we have it sewn together. And, you know, all these pinwheels will meet in the middle as well. But this is still giving us a pretty clean sense of this for the first time. Without all the blobs everywhere. There we go! It's gonna look pretty cute, I think. Yeah, so let's, with the overlap, I just want to peek quick. When we have these together and it's on that seam, it'll be more like, I can't even do it, more like this, where this blue won't be running into that blue. So yeah, that'll be exciting. So all right, guys, next thing up is we will sew all these segments together. I'll probably sew them together by twos, so each corner I'll sew together. And then I'll have like a four patch left to sew together. You know, then we'll sew the top two squares and the bottom two squares, and then we'll sew all of it together. So that will be a chunk of time, but you know, maybe on Saturday. So I right now I'm still planning on doing my mini marathon on Saturday. So this might be a nice one to just get done. I'd like that. So, all right, guys, I'm going to flip you around. Yeah, so I think Saturday, I want to get this guy done. There's, you know, I want to get all the blocks done, but this one I want to get done. Here's the one with the little bunny kind of peeking on there, just barely. We won't be able to tell it's a bunny, but I'd like this one. It's just fun and graphic, just this triangle. I like it. So, all right, thanks for joining me here again, guys. This will go up on Penguin and Fish Movies on YouTube. It'll upload tonight, and I'll finish it up tomorrow morning, so probably tomorrow, late morning, it'll be available there. Otherwise, you can watch it again right away here on Facebook. It's on Penguin Ampersand Fish. If you can't find it in your feed anymore, that's where you can find it, just by doing a search for the Penguin and Fish page. And that's the deal. So thanks so much, guys, for coming in tonight. I love talking to you guys every night, and makes my day. So, all right, I will see you tomorrow for New Black Thursday. Have a great night, guys. Good night.